Hi everyone, my name's Michelle and I'm Mama Loves You GB here on FlossTube, but also over on Instagram and Etsy as well. Welcome to the Sunday morning briefing. It is the 2nd of October, but other than that I have no further information. I can't remember which FlossTube we are. We're somewhere in the 90s, I think, for the kind of regular edition of FlossTube. It's been one of those weeks. It started off with last week, with the hacking and the spamming. We'll talk more about that in a moment. But it's just been one of those weeks, you know, when you're normally just kind of talking along quite nicely and then the universe just goes, ah, you, I remember you, have this. So nothing catastrophic has happened, but it's just been one thing after another, after another, after another. So today, my mum and I went on a road trip to North Wales and we went to Create Nostalgia and Abercans. And the haul that I have proves the stress that I've been under this week. So if you want to stick around and have a look at that, then please do. So yeah, last week, what a scummy thing to do, to hack a nice bunch of cross stitches just trying to have a bit of a giveaway. Now, I think it may have been my fault. In part because I put giveaway in the title of the video. Now I've done that before and I know lots of other FlossTubers have done that before and nothing's ever happened, but it's not a mistake I'm going to make again. So we are going to have another go at the giveaway this week. I did end up having to turn off the comments from last week because with the hack, as much as I was deleting and reporting the comments, and you better believe it, I reported them for everything under the sun. Literally, oh, report them for that this time, yeah, that this time, that this time, that this time. There wasn't a block option, I couldn't block them. And so as soon as I was deleting them, I saw it was coming back up again. And so fingers crossed, we'll be okay this week. But please, please know, I would never ask you to text. I would never ask you for any money for shipping or anything like that. If I'm doing a giveaway, I'm covering the cost of the shipping. And sometimes that means that I may make it UK only, because I know that if it goes to the States, or if a lot of things end up going to the States, it's going to be expensive. And I'd rather do that than ask anybody for shipping money, because I don't think that's fair. So please know, I will never ask you to text. I would never ask you for shipping money. I would only ever contact you via Instagram DM or my own email. No other way. So I'm really sorry that some of you kind of got caught up in that. And I'm even more sorry that some of you were so excited because you thought you'd won one of the charts. Those hackers are good, aren't they? They are, yeah, good in a bad way, but they're convincing. They are convincing. So we're going to have another go at this chart. Because I felt sorry for Carol as well, because this is Carol's chart and we were trying to have a nice giveaway from Samplers and Stitches. The reason I'm saying Carol is because she's Carol X Stitch on Instagram. And Samplers and Stitches is her Etsy. So she had given me two copies of this to give away and we'd gone for the word Raven. So I'm hoping that if you entered last week and we're disappointed because we had to cut it short, I'm hoping very much that you will enter again this week. I'm going to leave it open for 2 weeks. Fingers crossed. And we'll see where we get to then. But if those hackers come back, man, I'm going to be so mad. I was so mad last week as well, because I was absolutely loving reading all of the comments about the video and about how much people enjoyed the taste box, again, the try treats box, and the look on my face apparently was an absolute picture. So if you do want to leave any comments about last week, then please leave them on this video. But I know a lot of you messaged me on Instagram and emailed me actually to say how much you'd enjoyed that, which was really nice to hear, because I didn't realize kind of how much I missed that little bit of contact during the week of looking at my comments and responding to the comments where I can. So yeah, let's try again. Fancy. I thought porn people were bad enough, coming putting porn links on my channel, but the hackers are worse. So let's have a look and see what I've stitched. So I've got some stuff that I've stitched. I have got a freebie chart as always, and then I've got quite a lot of haul. There was already a reasonable amount had come in before, and yeah, I went a little bit mad today. I've also had some fabulous stitchy kindness, which I will tell you about later on. So let me just show you what I've been stitching on. I've had a bit more of a go at this one by the Elfin Forest, and I'll put a picture up of the chart up here. And now I've got something in my eye. Oh dear. There we go. So apologies that I haven't ironed anything, because I generally was worried that the iron would blow up. That would just finish it off. So that's where I am with the Elfin Forest. I did have a bit of other stuff done down here, but I think I told you I decided to stitch it in one strand of black silk and decided it wasn't quite what I wanted and switched to a sulky, which was giving me a better coverage. So I've now picked out his other foot and where his wings would come down here. But other than that, that's all I've got to go on that one. So I stitched on that. I also stitched on this one, which is Glendon Place Phantom Plantation, right there in big letters at the top, Michelle. Phantom Plantation. Now I did most of this while I was waiting for my video to upload last week, and then on the Sunday as well, before I started dealing with comments. So what I've done, grab the pattern back again. What I've done is I've kind of come down here, and then I'm going to go across and up this tree here. And again, I haven't ironed it, but that's where I am. So that's what it looks like. You can't see my face, which is potentially better. And there we go. So I've started to do this ghoul. So this is the main kind of ghoul that's going to be in the cart with the skeleton horse. So I've done him and part of the cart. There is a wheel there somewhere. Most of this has got to be backstitch, so it will stand out more from the fabric. And then where my needle is sticking out randomly, I've done a little bit of grass, and I'm coming along into the tree roots. So the tree roots have got a darker brown to go on them as well. So again, like I said, I'm not worried about anything standing out, because once I've got that all backstitched, it'll be fab. And then, I mustn't lose that, that's my list. I wouldn't be able to put it there without bodging you. I'll put it there. And as promised, on the 1st of October, let me get the right month, I started Una's Urn by Colleen, who's Rebel Stitcher Designs, and you can get these as PDFs. So I started this one yesterday. It literally just came together. I thought, oh, there's no way I'm going to be able to get that done, because I've been finishing up my chart that is my swap. I'm doing a swap. So I've been finishing all that up, ready to go. I didn't get it in the post in the end because of the postal strike, so I thought it'd be better just to keep hold of it until Monday. But yeah, so that is perfect. That is what I've stitched on. So this is where I got to. I'm going to put this behind here. So this is a piece of 32 count even weave that I dyed myself. And this piece is actually in the video special edition that I did for dyeing with walnut dye. And that's where I've got to. So I've got most of the pumpkin outlined. I've started on this band of skulls that form part of the urn. Got one of these really cool kind of eye-like flowers, and then some of the other foliage. And I really love this one. As soon as you saw it, I loved it. I am stitching it with this little bag of random colours that I had picked out. I had a couple of the called for, so I had onyx and clockwork and hickory sticks, and then the rest of them I've just made up, just basically whatever I had on my ring that I thought looked like it might be an appropriate colour, and that's what I'm doing. So I just love this fabric. I think I'm going to have to dye some more of this fabric. So this is actually the back, that is the front, so that's where you've got all of the most of the walnut dye that was in the spray bottle. So you've got a mottled front to it, and I do like that side, but for this design I actually preferred the back. So I'm going to do some more like that and maybe get a couple of different colours, because you can do exactly the same thing with Rit dye. Put it in a little spray bottle, it has to be quite a fine spray bottle, put it in a bottle and then just take it outside, spray it, let it drip, let it do whatever it wants to, and then you just pick whichever side you like. And as I said, I preferred this side. So really pleased with that. If you want to join in the stitch along, all you need to do is go on to rebelstitcher.com or Rebel Stitcher Designs and get the chart and then piece of fabric. The chart itself is 97 by 73 excuse me, stitches, so it's not huge. It's definitely doable this month and probably finishable. I say that because I haven't finished anything for ages, but it should be finishable. We'll see. It's definitely stitchable this month, but whether I get around to finishing it, we shall see. And then, yeah, I think pretty much everything else I have is haul or Stitchy Kindness. So let me just do the freebie. So the freebie is by Night Spirit Studio, and it's called I Dress Like This Every Day. And so it's a really nice little Halloween one with lots of little candy corns around the outside and various different pumpkins and just some cool texting. So I thought that was really nice. And I'll of course put the link to it down below. What else have I got in my pile? Oh, I printed out this to show you. This is from the newest edition of Christmas Cross Stitch from Just Cross Stitch. So it's the Christmas special. And if you are a Readly member, then you can get that on Readly. Sometimes it appears when you search for Just Cross Stitch, and sometimes you have to type in Just Cross Stitch specials. But I really like that. I thought that was really cool. Just a little woodpecker on what looks like a silver birch. And it's designed by Panochka. Now Panochka, I'm guessing they must be Russian because they were on Etsy, but they're not on Etsy anymore. But obviously this design has gone into the cross stitch Christmas edition. So I just thought I'd show you that one. There's lots of others. I haven't done a complete flick through and I haven't printed off loads of things that I want to stitch. But that one, I'd seen it 2 or 3 weeks ago and it just kind of, you know, when you get little headworm and it just keeps swirling around in your brain. So I printed that one off and I thought I'd show it to you. Right. Stitchy Kindness. I received 2 bits of Stitchy Kindness. First of all, I've got this lovely card from Sian, who won a giveaway from me, 3 or 4 weeks ago now, by the time I'd actually got it posted and whatever. So she sent me this, and this is a Hands Across the Sea one. The front cover is Elizabeth Weston. And if you don't know about Hands Across the Sea, they do, on the back of their cards, a pattern. Now, if you manage to get that, then, yeah, you'll never stitch it. So it's so small. The chart is, what's it say? It doesn't say 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 75 by 75 by 75, and it basically says forget me not in the middle with some kind of floral border. So if you you ever had a Hands Across the Sea card sent to you, check the back, because they've all got different ones on them. Or if you're thinking about getting a nice gift for some Stitchers come Christmas time, then I think these are a really nice gift for Stitchers. Some cards that they can then send to other Stitchers, because we like getting cards. Now, the other Stitchy kindness that I had, I was absolutely blown away. A lady called Julie contacted me and said that she wanted to send me a box of her stash because she'd kind of lost her Stitchy mojo. She wasn't really into it or into the things that she'd got anymore, and so she just wanted to send it. And so I said, oh, thank you very much. And I said, I'll use some of it for giveaways and bits and bobs. Well, this enormous box turned up and I was absolutely blown away. There was fabric, charts, threads, lots and lots of series of charts. So for example, the Country Cottage Needleworks, Little House Needleworks, the Little House series, there's several of those. Lots of them have got their threads in. I was absolutely blown away. So thank you so much, Julie. I know I've messaged you to say thank you, and there will be something in the post to you, but just amazing, absolutely amazing. So I've been sorting them through, reuniting the threads with the charts, and so I shall start doing some giveaways with those definitely before Christmas. So watch out for those. I couldn't believe it. It was amazing. Okay, fabric, Fox and Rabbit. I have sent out the Fox and Rabbit charts. No, not charts, threads, no, fabric. If you can arrange the words in this video into a meaningful set of sentences, then please let me know. In my defense, I'm really tired because we left at 7:30 this morning, and it's about a 3-hour drive up to Create Nostalgia. Then it's about another 20 minutes or so to Abergann's, and then so it's about a 4-hour drive on the way back. And we stopped at McDonald's for a breakfast in Aberystwyth. Now, I've never had a McDonald's breakfast, and I don't like egg anyway. But we thought, oh yeah, we'll grab that. Oh my God. Talk about swill. It was disgusting. So I had a bacon roll with brown sauce. There was so much brown sauce in this thing. It was just like dripping. And you know, when like we ate it sort of in the car, not driving the car, but in the car, and there was just sauce everywhere, just sauce. And then I had hash brown as well, which was tasty. I'll give them the hash brown, but then it's almost impossible to mess up a hash brown, I think. On a scale of like 1 to 10, it's almost impossible to mess up a hash brown. And then I had this cup of tea, apparently. It was disgusting. It really was genuinely disgusting. So yeah, 0 out of 10 McDonald's. I have to really be in the mood for a McDonald's anyway. But it does happen occasionally. Right, where was I before I really interrupted myself? Fabric of the Month Club from Fox and Rabbit. Now, if you don't want to see, I suggest you look away for a couple of minutes. I won't say anything. I'll just hold them up. So if you want to look away, then you won't see them, because we posted them out, but obviously we're into the postal strike. So you'll be getting it soon. So if you don't want to see, then I won't say anything. You can just look away and then I'll tell you when to look back. So this is the first one. And this is the second one. I'm going to open the second one out a bit because you need to be able to see how amazing it is. Okay, you can look back. You can look back. If you looked away, you can look back. And I'm sure that everybody who did stay and watch them will be rooting for you when you actually get yours, because they are beautiful, beautiful. Okay, what did I get from Create Nostalgia? this little pile of stuff. Now, the first thing I meant to say, before I forget, is I noticed on the counter that Mary has some of the original thread heaven in the little blue boxes. So I know that's discontinued, and if you like it and have been running short, then she's got some. So I'm not sure whether it will show up on her website, but if you give her a call, she'll be able to put some in the post to you. So, there's a funny story about this chart. So when you go to create nostalgia, and as we did off the back of a really long drive, the first thing is like, can I go to the loo, please? And when you go to the loo, there's this whole wall of all this most beautiful, beautiful needlework. There's a couple of old samplers, and then there's lots and lots of ones that has been stitched by Mary, or I know her mum was really into needlework. So I don't know who stitched them, but they're beautiful. So while I was waiting, because my mum came with me, because she's now into stitching as well, which is great. So while I was waiting, I was looking at the needlework on the wall. And I'd seen this chart done by Lisa Smith, Kindred Stitcher. And I tried to find it, and I couldn't find it because it is basically out of print. But she still had some. She still had some. And it's by Hillside Samplings, and it is called Gathering Pine Cones. And that is what it looks like. Now, those pine cones are all made up of various different speciality stitches. So you've got Jerusalem cross, fly stitch, fishbone, point ochre. Any others? There must be a couple of others. Queen stitch, pin stitch, pavilion diamonds, continental stitch, scotch stitch, fishbone stitch. It tells you how to do all of these different stitches, which is good because I'm going to need that information. But I saw, as I said, Lisa Smith had finished hers, and it looks absolutely amazing. And there is a chart for the pin cushion as well. So the pin cushion has got quite a lot of the same stitches in it. So it may well be that I do the pin cushion first to give me a good chance at doing the bigger one. So I've worked it all out by the time I get to it. So I can't wait to do that. That is stitched on R&R Reproductions, but what? That is a good question. Something by R&R Reproductions. Well, I'm sure you don't need to watch me try and find out. No doubt I'll get back to you when I start stitching it. So yeah, if you're looking for any Hillside Samplings, then again, give Mary a call. I don't know how many of them are on her website, but give her a call and see what she's got. I also picked up this little Mill Hill, the bear in the little canoe. Now I think it was Amy Loves Toads, maybe, that had done this once or had it, and I absolutely loved it. So I grabbed that. It's meant to be a magnet. I'm struggling with words today. It's meant to be a magnet, but I will be doing it just as a little ornament, and I'll probably put a hanging loop on it as well. So I got that. And then I got some water lilies, some Caron water lilies. So I've got these three colours. Now I've got bittersweet, cardinal and pine forest. And I wanted to use these because in that Phantom Plantation, I loved stitching the moon, and the moon is stitched with Caron water lilies. And I've got the Quaker stocking, and so I wanted to stitch the Quaker stocking in silk. Now I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to do, but I thought I might do maybe something with those two. That orange is a bit brighter than it's looking, so I thought I'd maybe do something with those two, and maybe one straight colour, or one sort of flat colour, or I might do something with that. I'm not sure. but I definitely wanted some more of those. I picked up this from All Through the Night, which is just a really, really simple little Christmas stitch. But again, I think it will look nice finished in a shape. It may even work on perforated paper. That may look nice on perforated paper. We shall see. We shall see. And then I grabbed a little bit of fabric, some 32 count fabric. So 32 count linen golden needle, which I think may be a Permin one. I'm not 100%. Or is it a Zweiger? I don't have a salvage, so it's either one of those two. But I just liked the tone of it. And I also liked this one, silver blue. And that doesn't have a salvage on it either. That's a 28 count. And then I picked up this one. Now I've had this before, but this one just looked a little bit darker and a little bit kind of moodier. So this is Vintage Stone Grey from Zweigart, a 32 count. And I've had it before, I've stitched on it before, but this one just looked, in the shop, it just looked darker than normal. So whether it is or not, I don't know. But I've got an idea about what I want to put on it as well. Right, Abacans haul. So that for those of you who don't know, Abacans is a fabulous fabric shop. And they do a lot of other crafts as well, like knitting and other different types of sewing, curtain making, anything, patchwork, anything. And I wanted to pick up some Fat Quarters. Well, actually, I had no intention of picking anything up at all. But I did. So I picked up some Fat Quarters. So they had an offer of 6 Fat Quarters for £10, I think. So, have I got them all there? No, I haven't. Let's just take everything out of the bag. A great episode this, isn't it? Watching someone ferret around in a bag. Right, these are my 10 that I got for... No, 6 that I got for £10. So, a nice black one with just a little kind of Christmassy... Could be Christmassy, doesn't have to be Christmassy. A nice green. Almost looks a little bit kind of batik. I love the way they fold their Fat Quarters as well. This one's really cool. It's got little deers on it and it's kind of like a mustardy colour. A stripe? Is that a stripe or a flag? Oh no, it is just a stripe. I suddenly thought I was going to unfurl it then and see the stars and the stripes, but no, just a stripe. And a check. Is it a buffalo check they call it? And a smaller buffalo check. So great, I thought, for Christmas finishing, but also for, doesn't have to be Christmas, it's not out and out Christmas. And then I bought these two as well. They had them on reduced. It's my favourite word. So I got this one. And fold that one so you can see it a little bit better. And then I picked up this one as well. This one wasn't reduced, but I just liked it. A little Halloween one, but first coffee, death before decaf. Because I have got a couple of witchy stitcher patterns that I want to do for my partner because he really likes coffee. And that will be perfect. And then you go into another part of Abacans and they sell their fabrics by weight. And they've just got this into massive room where it's all sorted out into craft cottons, into spandex, into like all this amazing fur stuff. It's amazing. And then you just take the piece that you want, and provided there's a meter left in the piece, you can have it cut. So if you take it to the counter and there's 3 meters there and you only want a meter, that's fine. You can have it cut and then they put the other 2 meters back. if you take it and there's 1.50 meters and you only want a meter, they won't cut it, you just have to take it as it is. So I found some really cool panels for making some quilts. The best laid plans of mice and men. So this was all sold by weight. So I got all this fabric for something like 20 quid. It was amazing. So this is a panel. And I bought a very long time ago a pack of about 18 fat quarters, which are just rainbow colours, and they've got a very slight pattern on each one, but nothing in your face. So what I thought I would do is use those to make a border and try and follow the rainbow around. So that's one thing I bought fabric for. And then I found this. And I knew that the rest of the crowd in the house would love this because it's about going to the woods, which is what they did today when we went fabric shopping. I said to Ness, she's like, where are you and Granny going? I said, we're going to a fabric shop. And she went, so she wasn't worried that she didn't get to come. So it just says, and I'm welcome to the woods, and then it's got this big moose at the bottom. So I picked that up, again by weight, so it was really nothing very much. And then I picked up four different other cottons to go with it. And I folded one of them wrongly, there we go. Four different other cottons to go with it to make the border. And I've got an idea of how I'm going to make it. So, just a very plain, it's a very fine stripe. And a dark green, a nice mottled beige. I ended up with quite a big piece of that because it couldn't be cut down. But it's, I think that'll come in useful for lots of things. And then a red. So I shall be using those four to make the border to go around that panel. And the last thing I have to show you, I didn't buy from Abacans. This came earlier on in the week. And it was actually my mum that spotted these. And I was like, oh, we'll give them a go. So we both bought a pack of these. Now, I'll put it on the windowsill. Ready to go, plugged in. So I can't lift it too much more because that's where the plug is. I've not got a massively long cord on, but I think it'll work. So this is a little light by Auraglow. Now I'm going to a retreat in 2 weeks' time. I'm going to Stitch in London. So if you're going to Stitch in London, let me know down below because I keep getting these recurring nightmares that people are going to recognise me and I'm not going to recognise anyone. And yeah, so let me know if you're going, let me know your Instagram so that I can try and, you know as many people as I can before we go. So it's this little light. It's got a little gooseneck. And it works on a USB, so it can go straight into a USB plug or a laptop or whatever you've got. And then that's the kind of warm light. That's the cool light. That's a dimmer light, and that's off. And then this is a charger for your phone. So it's a magnetic charger for your phone. Now, we bought these from QVC. And like I say, they came in a pack of two. The pack of two was just over £10, plus postage. I think it was about £3 or £4 postage. Two for £10. And you can see how small it goes. So it's not going to take up much room in your bag. Now, I wasn't sure whether I'm going to need one. As I stitch in hand, blind myself. There's a good one. Let's put that down. Because I stitch in hand, I don't generally have a lot of the additional paraphernalia, the clip-on things, the needle minders, the frames, all of that sort of stuff. And so I hadn't really thought about taking a light. And then I thought, maybe actually, I don't know what it's gonna be like. I'd already planned to take something that was maybe 32 count rather than anything slightly smaller, because I know I can see that fine. But then I thought, you know what, for £10, just over £10, I'll give those a go. And we're both really, really impressed with them, so much so that my mum's ordered another set to go home. So I'm gonna have two here, and she's gonna have two at home, just in case we ever need an emergency light. If you've stuck with this video this long, oh, thank you. It's hopefully normal service will resume next week and I won't look quite so frazzled. But there we go. It's been lovely to chat with you and I'll see you next week. Stay classy, Stitches.